Oh, did I make you jump? Sorry about that. I didn't mean to scare you. Welcome to another Full English video lesson, coming to you from the birthplace of Kate Bush, David Cameron, Basil Brush, Wallace and Gromit, and of course the English language. It can literally open doors for you, especially if you ask someone to open a door for you in English. Do you mind opening the door for me? Okay, enough of this idle, incoherent waffle and pointless gibberish. Let's get on with today's full English lesson right now. It's funny how some English phrases have more than one use. Here is a good example of this occurrence. The phrase take off can be used in many ways. You can take off something, as in removing it. To peel off something or to remove one thing from another is to take off. You can take off the paint from an object, such as a door or wall. You can take off your clothes. To remove something is to take off. To mimic or impersonate someone is to take off. To copy the mannerisms of a person, such as their movements and voice, is to take off. His takeoff of Elvis Presley was really convincing. To delete something from a list, you will need to take off that item. I had to take off the names of the absent students. To lift off from the ground in an aircraft is to take off. You take off in an aeroplane. The plane is ready to leave the ground.
Can you please tell the passengers to prepare for takeoff?
There is also takedown, which describes the action of making a written record of something. I will need to take down your name and address. Take down can also mean dismantle. To slowly break something apart with care is to take down something. We will have to take down the tent tomorrow when the wind is not so strong. To destroy a person's reputation with criticism can be described as a takedown. You defeat someone by criticizing them. A website that is removed from the internet is a takedown. The owners of the website were given a takedown notice by the government. Even the word take can be used in many ways. To steal something is take. The way you view something is take. What is your take on the situation in Syria? To film a sequence that has been prepared in advance is a take. You might have to do many takes of something before you get it right. Let's go again with another take. I hope we get it right this time. To transport something from one place to another is also take. You can take a person to the airport in your car. You can take some clothes out of the wardrobe. To take in is to give a home to someone. You might take in a homeless person during the winter months. To relax or consider something for a while, or to process something, is to take time. It will take time for you to recover from your injuries. There are so many uses of the word take. It's true. You can take my word for it. I don't know about you, but sometimes it is hard to resist being nosy. Some say that it is human nature to be curious about other people's lives. One point in particular is the action of listening to a conversation that you are not a part of. You cannot resist listening to what they are saying. Perhaps you are sitting in a cafe, and at the table next to you, a couple are having an argument, albeit quietly. They are having some sort of disagreement. You can't resist listening to what they are saying. Sometimes it is hard to hear what the conversation is about. You try to listen to them. You desperately try to hear their words. We call this action eavesdropping. You eavesdrop on a conversation. You listen in. The problem with eavesdropping is that if you get caught doing it, those having the private conversation might not be too happy. Hey, we are trying to have a private conversation here. Don't be so nosy. To spy on someone and listen to what they are saying in private can also be described as eavesdropping. We can say you are earwigging. You overhear something. You listen in on a conversation. It is possible to accidentally hear a conversation. You hear it by chance. Do you ever eavesdrop? It's time now to take a look at another buzzword. A buzzword is a phrase or sentence that is popular during a certain period of time, or is commonly used in general. Today's buzzword is controversy, or controversy. The word controversy is a noun which means a row in response or a negative reaction to something. A strong reaction to something such as someone's personal opinion or a provocative action. His words caused controversy throughout the world. You can create controversy by saying something inflammatory or provocative. The words used cause anger and outrage. To speak in a way that offends people, a controversy usually involves people with opposing views. One group agrees or holds the same opinion, whilst the other group disagrees, thus creating controversy. The occurrence of the controversy is described as controversial, a controversial plan, a controversial idea, a controversial film, a controversial speech. Controversial is the adjective form of controversy. The president has announced controversial reforms to the healthcare service. The controversial thing creates controversy. It is controversial because one group objects while another accepts. A person who causes controversy is controversial. He or she is a controversial character. The word controversy comes from the Latin word for turn around, which refers to an opposing view or the actual disagreement. Synonyms of controversy include altercation, disagreement, dispute, opposition, quarrel, wrangle. The overall disagreement over something in society can be described as controversy. The subject in question is controversial. Here is an interesting grammar point that is often mentioned in your messages. What is the difference between everyday and every day as separate words? Onto and onto as separate words. Into and into as separate words. Firstly, everyday describes something that frequently happens or occurs often. This is my everyday coat. It is something that is frequently happening. Then there is everyday as separate words, which is the adverb form of each day. I go to town every day to look around the shops. This is the adverb for each day. Then there is onto as a complete word. This is used as a preposition, However, it is not recognised in formal British English. He jumped onto the horse. In British English, we will always use the words separately. The bus went on to Piccadilly Circus. You can see here you have the adverb plus the preposition to continue. Finally, there is into as a complete word. This is the only form of this preposition. He jumped into the lake to cool off. This is a preposition to show movement or change. The only times we use in and to next to each other is through normal sentence structure. For example, we need to go in to find out what happened. The two words just happen to be next to each other, but they have their own uses in the sentence. Did I clearly explain that to you? Was my explanation adequate? I hope so. Life is full of surprises. You never really know what is round the corner. Life is unpredictable, and quite often you can find yourself being caught on the hop. I love that expression. To get caught on the hop means to be caught unawares and unprepared. If you are distracted by something you are doing, then it is possible to suddenly be caught on the hop. You are caught off guard and forced into a difficult situation by being unprepared. This phrase is often used in British English. We can also say that a person who is busy doing something is on the hop. They are bustling. They are active. They are actively doing something. They are on the hop. Another great phrase for being unprepared is caught with your pants down. A person who has been put in a difficult position by being unprepared for something has been caught with their pants down. The regional manager's visit caught us all with our pants down. The inquiry caught many politicians with their pants down. To be caught on the hop. To be caught with your pants down. You were not ready for what happened. For most of us, it's just another day in this crazy thing we call life. Sadly, we have come to the end of another Full English lesson. See you next time for Full English number 31. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, and I will see you again, whether it is recorded or live. I will be here somewhere on YouTube. This is Mr. Duncan in the birthplace of English. Of course, that is England, saying thanks for watching, enjoy English, and of course, ta-ta for now.